In this video, I would like to demonstrate the level menu. The first item on the level menu is to set the reference level. The reference level is the level at the top of the screen, and you can always see it indicated here at the top left corner. The ref level is normally set automatic to ensure that the strongest signal is just visible. And if there's no strong signal, that the noise is at the bottom of the screen. But there are certain situations where it makes sense to set the ref level to a manual mode. One of those is, for instance, when you have a signal that varies in level, then it means that the signal jumps up and down the screen. And in that case, it makes sense to set the ref level to an automatic level. And for instance, we set it here to 0. And then you can easily see that the signal makes a certain change while the noise stays at the same level. Next to the ref level, you can also set the scale per division. By default, this is set to 10, as you can see here at the left side of the screen. But if necessary, you can set it to a different value. For instance, if you have strong signals, you can go for 20. But if you want to see a lot of detail, then you can also set it to 5. And back again to 10. The next setting on the level menu is the attenuate setting. Normally, the attenuation is in auto mode, and there the TinySA tries to find a good compromise between not too much noise, so not bring the noise floor too much up, and to prevent overloading of the TinySA. The current attenuation is automatically set to 20 dB, as you can see here at the right. And I'm going to demonstrate what happens if you override this and what do you get. The first thing that I'm going to do is to bring the attenuation to 0 dB. And you will notice that the marker info at top turns red. And that's because the level that gets at the mixer is now above minus 10 dB. And that is a level that for sure will create internal harmonics. So you have to be very careful to understand what you are doing when you're overloading. And that's why you get this warning. Now, if I set the ref level to manual 0 dB, and I switch between 0 dB attenuation, like it is set now, and I set it to 20 dB attenuation, as it was when it was an automatic, you will notice that the noise floor moves up. The signal at the top stays at the same, because the TinySA in its level measurements compensates for this change in attenuation. But if the attenuation increases, the noise floor moves up. And that's why you always have to have a compromise between not too much, but also not too little attenuation. I'm going back to manual automatic attenuation here. The next setting on the level menu is the unit submenu. There are a number of units in which the measurement can be displayed. The default setting is dBm, and that's in decibel per microwatt. That's the most conventional setting. But sometimes you want to measure in a different unit, and there are two additional logarithmic units, dBmV and dBmicroV. And there are two linear units, volt and watt. The dBmV is just a scaling, a shifting of the levels, and it behaves very much like the dBm. Also, the dB microV is again a shift of the level. So again, very similar behavior, but the volt and the watt are linear units, so they look very different. Because if you have the volt unit displayed, then you will see that all the noise seems to be gone. The bottom of the screen is now set to zero, but because there is such a huge dynamic range in a linear scale, you're unable to see the noise. Also in the watt unit, you don't see the noise. But you can immediately see that my signal generator is producing around 300 microwatt. Sometimes you want to measure very strong or very weak signal sources. And for that, the external amp menu option is interesting. It allows you to specify the external attenuation or external amplification that has been applied to the signal. It's a known amplification or known attenuation. And that will compensate the screen, the level readings on the screen, so that you know what is actually being delivered. For instance, if my previous signal would not be coming from a signal generator, but from a transmitter, and I'm using a 60 dB attenuator to get the signal from the transmitter into the tiny SA, I can enter here 60 as the, sorry, minus 60 as the attenuation. And I can see that my transmitter is at slightly below 300 watt, which saves you again a lot of calculation effort. The last item in the level menu is the trigger submenu. And to demonstrate that, I've switched to the high mode, center frequency 434 megahertz, 10 megahertz span. And I'm interested here to capture the frequency of some signals that are very briefly present. For instance, you see sometimes some peak appearing, but they're never long. So I would like to trigger the measurement so that I capture this sporadic signal. One way to do it is put the tiny SA in normal trigger mode, and then you have to set the trigger level, and I'm setting the trigger level to minus 70. And the blue line, which is not well visible on the video, but in reality it's better visible, is the trigger level. Now, and as soon as there is a signal that is stronger than minus 70 dB, it's being captured and it stays there. But of course, if you only want to capture it once, you can put it also in single trigger mode. Here you can see it is armed by the text armed there. And then once a signal has been seen that is stronger than the threshold, the display goes into paused to notify that a signal has been captured. And now it's easy to see the strength of the signal and the frequency of the signal. The last option in the trigger menu is the trigger direction, going up or going down. To demonstrate that, I have set the tiny SA into zero span mode, with a sweep time of 2.1 seconds at the center frequency of 10 megahertz. And I have a signal generator that sweeps the level from minus 55 to minus 15 dBm. And to have a nice readout, I would like to get the start of the signal, the ramp up, at the start of the screen. I can do that by going into normal trigger mode and set the trigger level to minus 50. And then I can select whether I want to trigger on the up edge, which is currently selected, or on the down edge, which I've selected now. In this case, it doesn't make a big difference. But if I set the trigger level, for instance, to minus 40, this is the down edge, and this is the up edge.